Srikant Atwarthy, you watching Srikant Adult Chemistry. In this video, we are discussing about numericals based on empirical formula and molecular formula. So this is the first problem. A gaseous compound of nitrogen and hydrogen contains 12.5% by weight of hydrogen. The density of the compound relative to the hydrogen is 16. The molecular formula of the compound is. Okay. When you observe the question, they give the percentage of hydrogen. And they said the gaseous compound having only nitrogen and hydrogen. So if you fill the total percentage of compound is equal to 100, in that hydrogen is 12.5, rest of the percentage is equal to percentage of nitrogen. And they give one more clue, the density of compound related to hydrogen is 16. I mean, they give the vapor density. By using of vapor density, we can find the molecular weight. And they are asking about molecular formula of the compound. So when percentages is given, to find the molecular formula, first we need to find the empirical formula. By using of empirical formula, we can find the molecular formula. So for this, so here I just take some columns. Serial number, element, percentage, atomic weight, relative ratio, and simple ratio. So there are the some columns to solve this problem. So first we just take the given elements. So in the given compound, the elements are nitrogen and hydrogen. The percentage of hydrogen is 12.5, and percentage of nitrogen is 100 minus 12.5, I mean 87.5, and the atomic weight of nitrogen is 14, and atomic weight of hydrogen is 1. So here relative ratio means the ratio between percentage of element to atomic weight. Listen carefully, relative ratio means the ratio between a percentage of element to atomic weight, I mean 87.5 by 14, you get a 6.25. Here 12.5 by 1, we get a 12.5. Then simple ratio. Here simple ratio means we need to divide the all values with the least value. So in 6.25 and 12.5, the least value is 6.25. So with the 6.25, we need to divide the all things. Then we get 6.25 by 6.25 is equal to 1. 12.5 by 6.25 is equal to 2. So this is simple ratio we call as. Suppose in the simple ratio, if we have any decimal values, to round up the decimal values, we need to another column, that is a whole ratio. For that category also, I will give one example later. So then here the digits representation of simple ratio for each element is indication of a number of atoms of element. So here empirical formula. Here what we get, the number of atoms in the simple ratio, indication of empirical formula. Here empirical formula is NH2. Why? Because for nitrogen we get 1, for hydrogen we get 2. So here the simple ratio is indication of number of atoms of elements, 1 nitrogen, 2 hydrogen. So the empirical formula is NH2. But they're asking about a molecular formula, not about a empirical formula. So to find the molecular formula, here we have one formula, that is a molecular formula is equal to empirical formula twice n, and at the same time here small n is equal to molecular formula weight by empirical formula weight. So first we to get the molecular formula, we need to get the empirical formula and n value. We already have the empirical formula. So first we need to find the n value. To get the n value, we need molecular formula weight by empirical formula weight. So here molecular formula weight is equal to, in the given problem they give the density of compound related to hydrogen is 16, So I mean they give the vapor density. So molecular weight is equal to 2 into vapor density. Here vapor density is given as 16. 2 into 16 we get 32. And we need the one more thing. That is a empirical formula weight. It is derived from empirical formula. So empirical formula weight is equal to 1 nitrogen 14, 2 hydrogen 2. Totally we get a 16. Now substitute the molecular formula weight and empirical formula weight. In the place of n, we get the n value. Then n is equal to molecular formula weight 32 by empirical formula weight 16 is equal to 2. So the value of n is equal to 2. Now substitute these n value here. So molecular formula is equal to empirical formula NH2 into small n value 2 we get. So now open the bracket. So here 1 is there. 1 into 2, 2. 2 into 2, 4. So the molecular formula of the compound is N2H4. So this is the way of solution of problems when percentage of elements is given and empirical formula and molecular formula is asking. That's all. Okay students, so this is next question. The percentage of carbon, hydrogen and nitrogen in an organic compound are 40%, 13.3% and 46.7% respectively. Then empirical formula is. So they ask empirical formula. So first we take the some columns. Element. Percentage. Atomic weight, relative ratio, and a simple ratio. So first we take the elements. Those are carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen. Percentage of carbon 40, hydrogen 13.3, and nitrogen is 46.7. And atomic weight of carbon is 12, hydrogen is 1. Nitrogen is 14. So relative ratio. Relative ratio means ratio between percentage and atomic weight of element. I mean 40 by 12 is equal to 3.33 and 13.3 by 1 is equal to 13.3. 46.7 by 14 is equal to 3.34. So this is about relative ratio. And simple ratio. How can you find the simple ratio? We need to divide the all values with least value. Here least value is 3.33. So divide the all value with 3.33. Here we get 1. 13.3 by 3.33. Here we get 4. 3.34 by 3.33. Here also we get 1 approximately. So in simple ratio we got all our natural numbers. So here we take the empirical formula directly. So the empirical formula is equal to one carbon, four hydrogens and one nitrogen. So this is the empirical formula based on the given data. That's all. Okay students, this is next question. An organic compound contains 40% of carbon and 6.67% of hydrogen. Then find the empirical formula of the compound. So first we just take the columns. Element, percentage, atomic weight, relative ratio and simple ratio. Okay, then we just take the given elements, carbon, hydrogen. The percentage of carbon is given as 40 and hydrogen is given as 6.67%. But the total percentage is not equal to 100. So the total percentage we get 46.67. So the rest of percentage is equal to oxygen. That is 53.33%. And atomic weight of carbon is 12. Hydrogen is 1, oxygen is 16. The relative ratio 40 by 12, we get 3.3. Here 6.67 by 1, is equal to 6.67. Here 53.33 is divided by 16, we get a 3.33. Then simple ratio, we need to divide the all values with least value. So here least value 3.33, so 3.33 by 3.33 is equal to 1. 6.67 by 3.33 is equal to 2, and 3.33 by 3.33 is equal to 1. So then the empirical formula, what is the empirical formula, is equal to one carbon, two hydrogens and one oxygen, I mean CH2O. This is the empirical formula of a given problem. That's all.
Friends, this is the next question. The empirical formula of a gaseous compound is CH2. The density of the compound is 1.25 grams per liter at STP. The molecular formula of the compound is, okay, when you observe the problem, they give the empirical formula. So first we just write the given information. Empirical formula is equal to CH2. And they ask about the molecular formula. So to find the molecular formula, first we need to find the molecular weight. So here they didn't give the molecular weight, but they give the density of the gas at STP. So when density of gas is given, to find the molecular weight, we have one formula, that is called P is equal to dRT by M. That implies M is equal to dRT by P. So at STP, the temperature is equal to 273 kelvins, and pressure is equal to 1 atmosphere, and R value is equal to 0.0821 liter atmosphere per mole Kelvin, and the density of the gas is 1.25 gram per liter. Now substitute all values in the formula of M is equal to dRT by P. Then M is equal to 1.25 into 0.0821 into 273 by 1 atmosphere. So after simplification of entire these factor, we get the 28. So the molecular weight of the compound is equal to 28. So empirical formula weight is equal to 1 carbon 12, 2 hydrogens 2, 12 plus 2, we get a 14. Sorry, and molecular formula weight is equal to 28. So here we have formula to find the molecular formula. Molecular formula is equal to empirical formula taken n, and n is equal to molecular formula weight by empirical formula weight. Molecular formula weight 28, empirical formula weight 14. We get n is equal to, substitute the n value here and substitute empirical formula here. Then C1H2 take N2, then we get the molecular formula is equal to C2H4. So this is the molecular formula of the given compound. Okay students, there are some models based on the empirical formula and molecular formula. If you like my concept, please subscribe to my channel, please like and share my videos. Thank you.